नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। एनलाइटनिंग टेक्स्ट 45 ऑफ चैप्टर 10 भागवतम इज द आंसर टू ऑल क्वेश्चंस और सेकंड कैंटो द कॉस्मिक मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ श्रीमद् भागवतम। टेक्स्ट 45, नास्य कर्मणि जन्मादौ परस्यानु विधीयते कर्तृत्व प्रतिषेधार्थम मायया रूपितम हि तत। देयर इज नो डायरेक्ट इंजीनियरिंग बाय द लॉर्ड फॉर द क्रिएशन एंड डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड। What is described in the Vedas about his direct interference is simply to counteract the idea that material nature is the creator. The Vedic direction for the creation, maintenance and destruction of the material world is this: Yato va imani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti yata prayanti abhisam vishanti. That is, everything is created by Brahma. After creation, everything is maintained by Brahma. And after annihilation, everything is conserved in Brahma. Gross materialists, without any knowledge of Brahma, Paramatma or Bhagwan, conclude material nature to be the ultimate cause of the material manifestation. And the modern scientists also shares this view that the material nature is the ultimate cause of all the manifestations of the material world. This view is refuted by all Vedic literature. The Vedanta philosophy mentions that Brahma is the fountainhead of all creation, maintenance and destruction, and Srimad Bhagavatam, the natural commentation on the Vedanta philosophy says, Janmadi asya yato anvayad itaratasha charthesva adhidnyah swarat etc. Inert matter is undoubtedly energy with potential to interact, but it has no initiative of its own. Srimad Bhagavatam therefore comments on the aphorism Janmadi asya by saying abhidnyah and swarat, that is, the supreme Brahma is not inert matter, but he is supreme consciousness and is independent. Therefore, inert matter cannot be the ultimate cause of the creation, maintenance and destruction of the material world. Superficially, material nature appears to be the cause of creation, maintenance and destruction, but material nature is set into motion for creation by the supreme conscious being, the personality of Godhead. He is the background of all creation, maintenance and destruction, and this is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita 9.10. Maya dhyakshen prakrutiha suyate sa characharam hetu na nen kaunteya jagat vipari vartate. The material nature is one of the energies of the Lord, and she can work under the direction of the Lord adhyakshen. When the Lord throws his transcendental glance over the material nature, then only can the material nature act as a father contacts the mother, who is then able to conceive a child. Although it appears to the layman that the mother gives birth to the child, the experienced man knows that the father gives birth to the child. The material nature therefore produces the moving and standing manifestations of the material world after being contacted by the Supreme Father and not independently. Considering material nature to be the cause of creation, maintenance etc. is called the logic of nipples on the neck of a goat. The Chaitanya Charitamrita by Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami describes this logic of ajagala stana nyaya as follows. As explained by His Divine Grace Sri Srimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Maharaj, the material nature as the material cause is known as pradhan, and as efficient cause is known as maya. But since it is inert matter, it is not the remote cause of creation. Kaviraj Goswami states as follows: Ata eva Krishna mula jagat karana prakrutiha karana yaiche ajagala stana Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi 5.61. Because Karanar Navashai Vishnu is a plenary expansion of Krishna, it is he who electrifies the matter to put it in motion. The example of electrification is quite appropriate. A piece of iron is certainly not fire, but when the iron is made red hot, certainly it has the quality of fire through its burning capacity. Matter is compared to the piece of iron, and it is electrified or made red hot by the glance or manipulation of the supreme consciousness of Vishnu. Only by such electrification is the energy of matter displayed in various actions and reactions. therefore the inert matter is neither efficient nor the material cause of the cosmic manifestation. Shri Kapil Dev has said, yathol mukat visvulingat dhumad vapi svasambhavat api atmatven bhimatad yathagniha prithak ulmukat Bhagavatam 3.28.40. The original fire, its flame, its sparks and its smoke are all one. For fire is still fire, yet is different from the flame. Flame is different from sparks and sparks are different from the smoke. In every one of them, namely in the flames, in the sparks and in the smoke, the integrity of fire is present, yet all of them are differently situated with different positions. The cosmic manifestation is compared to the smoke because when smoke passes over the sky, so many forms appear resembling many unknown and known manifestations. The sparks are compared to living entities and the flames are compared to material nature pradhan. One must know that each and every one of them is effective because of being simply empowered by the quality of the original fire. Therefore, all of them, namely the material nature, the cosmic manifestation and the living entities, are but different energies of the Lord Fire. Therefore, those who accept the material nature as the cosmic manifestation's original cause, Prakruti, the cause of creation, according to Sankhya philosophy, are not correct in their conclusion. The material nature has no separate existence without the Lord. Therefore, setting aside the Supreme Lord as the cause of all causes is the logic of Ajagala Stana Nyaya, or trying to milk the nipples on the neck of a goat. The nipples on the neck of a goat may seem like sources of milk, but to try to get milk from such nipples will be foolish. Hare Krishna.